Subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for the latest updated videos.
Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel Query Solution. So dear all, today we are going to start a new topic which is human brain, and in this topic I'll be covering about what is nervous system, what are the different subtypes of nervous system, the basic part of human brain, the structural details and the functions of different parts of brain. So even if you want to know all this into detail, do watch my video completely. And for now, let us start up with the video. Alright, so if we talk about the different subtypes of nervous system, so there are particularly three major subtypes of nervous system. One is known as PNS, one is known as ANS, and one is known as CNS. PNS is known as peripheral nervous system, ANS is known as autonomic nervous system, and CNS is known as central nervous system. So, as we discussed in our previous video also, we were particularly talking about the brain and spinal cord. In reflex action and reflex arc also, we majorly said that brain is responsible for analyzing and reflex action, and spinal cord and spinal nerves are actually responsible for responding in the case of reflex arc. So, these two major organs, that is brain and spinal cord, comes under the central part of body. You can also look up into this, like your brain is present in the central part and just down of the brain is present this cord which is known as your spinal cord. So since this forms the central part of your body, it comes under the central nervous system. Okay, now the next, let us look into what is autonomic nervous system. Now see, these autonomic nervous system, or particularly this autonomic nervous system, is responsible for controlling your involuntary actions. Now just see, if I'll remove in from this, so there are two types of actions which occur in your body. One is the voluntary action and one is the involuntary action. So first you should know the difference between both. Now voluntary action, voluntary, you can imagine, like you can understand this word voluntary. Sometimes we volunteer to do something, right? We do it by our choice. So in this case, and then if you are considering our body, what do you mean by voluntary actions? The actions which are controlled by our body. Like, I'll give you certain examples. Like in the case, if you want to go to, and if you want to play football, so that's your choice. You will get up, you will get ready, and you will go and play football. If your mother will give you a glass of milk, that's your choice that you will drink the milk or you will not drink the milk. Like for example, if I'm teaching you, it's your choice that you want to continue watching my video or you want to stop the video and you want to do some other activity. So whatever actions which are there in our control, they are known as voluntary actions, right? Whatever actions they are there in our control, which we can control, whatever we'll want to do, we'll do. Those are known as what? Those are known as voluntary action. So I think you can understand what is the meaning of involuntary action. Involuntary action means which are not there in our control. There are many actions in our body which are not under our control. Like you all know, beating of our heart, we can't control it. Breathing, we can't control it. Hunger, we can't control it. So all these functions which are not controlled by our body, those are known as involuntary actions. And such examples which I gave you of involuntary actions are controlled by which type of nervous system? The ANS, which is known as autonomic nervous system. As we already discussed, the part of analyzing and understanding whatever is happening around us is done by these two parts, that is the CNS part. Involuntary actions are controlled by the ANS part. Now let us look at what is this PNS. So PNS is known as peripheral nervous system, and this peripheral nervous system particularly contains the nerves which are present in our body. Now what are these nerves? First let us understand that. See, we all know that basic analyzing part is the brain. Whatever we do, whatever organs even are there in our body, they all coordinate with the brain. Whatever actions we perform, that happens with the help of CNS. But brain is present on the upper part of your body. just below the brain is present your cord, which is the spinal cord. So they are not, your brain is not connected to the legs. It is on one part, it is situated in one part of the body. Your legs are there at one part of the body. Your hands are there at one part of the body. Your heart is there at one part of the body. But all these organs are actually interrelated with each other. And how are they interrelated? They are interrelated with the help of nerves. These nerves are present all over our body and they are responsible for connecting the CNS, that is the brain and the spinal cord, to all other parts of the body. So how do they do that? Let us see. So there are two basic type of nerves. One of the nerves originate from the brain. Okay, one part of the nerve originate from the brain. Those are known as cranial nerves. And one part of the nerves originate from the spinal cord. You can relate it with the name itself, spinal cord. So those are known as spinal nerves. So as I said you, the basic function of nerves is to connect the CNS with different parts of the body. And how they'll connect? From the main part of CNS, that is brain and spinal cord, the nerves emerges, and these nerves connect us through the heart, through the legs, through the hand, and through all other part of the body. Okay, so these are basic three parts of the nervous system: peripheral, autonomic, and nervous. So let us start up with human brain now. So students, just see, this is a flowchart of a human brain. We'll be understanding this topic, of course, with the help of diagram, but that I'll do later on. First, I'll just explain you its different parts as per a flowchart, okay? And in case if you want to pen it down, you can also note down in your notes so that it will be helpful in your exams during understanding. Now, let me clear you one thing before starting human brain. Human brain is actually a very complex organ and it has got many details into it, but I am only covering the portion which is as per your standard, that is class 10th, and as per your CBSE prescribed and ICSE prescribed books. So I'll be covering only this much of topic today. Alright, for if you want to know this into more detail, I'll be uploading more videos of class 11th and 12th later on. So in that video, I'll be explaining this into more detail. So for now, I'm explaining this only up till class 10. So it is all as per your standard. You can completely go through it. Now just see. The human brain, if we look about, it has got its three main parts. The human brain has got its three main parts. What are those three parts? The first part is known as the forebrain. The next part is known as the midbrain. And the last part is known as the hindbrain. Now, I have written three words over here. So, you can analyze. The front part of the brain, whatever is there in the frontal part of the brain is known as the forebrain. The middle part of the brain is, of course, midbrain. And the lower down part of the brain is known as the hindbrain. Now, we all know, from brain is connecting the spinal cord. So spinal cord gets connected with which part of the brain? The hindbrain, that is the lower part of the brain. From this lower part, the spinal cord emerges and then it is present all in our the backside of our body. Now let us look at the different parts which you need to study. Again, I'm repeating, there are many parts, but it is all as per your standard, that is class 10th. Okay, so the forebrain contains two basic parts. One is known as cranium and one is known as cerebrum. Okay, the midbrain contains the main part which is known as what? Hypothalamus. And the hindbrain contains three main parts which are pons, medulla oblongata and cerebellum. Don't get confused between cerebellum and cerebrum. Cerebrum is present in the frontal part and cerebellum is present in the hindbrain part. Okay. Now, I will explain you all these parts with the help of diagram, but again, I'm saying I'm just explaining you with the help of flowchart and the functions of each part of the brain over here with the help of a flowchart. Okay, so first you understand this. Now, the forebrain part, which is present in the frontal part of our body, is responsible for controlling our voluntary actions, whereas the midbrain is actually responsible for controlling our involuntary actions. Now, I have already explained you the difference between voluntary and involuntary, so I will not be explaining you that again. In case if you have got doubt, you can of course ask to me in the comment section, but please go through the video, you will be able to understand. So forebrain controls are voluntary actions, and these are certain examples of it, whereas the midbrain controls the involuntary actions. These are the certain examples of it. But in hindbrain, there are different parts which control voluntary and different parts which control the involuntary actions. Like medulla oblongata is responsible for the involuntary action, so it works along with the midbrain. The hypothalamus and medulla oblongata works together to control involuntary actions like BP, heartbeat, vomiting, salivations, etc. Whereas the cerebellum part controls the voluntary actions of the body. And one of the very basic function of cerebellum is balancing our body. Now, what is the meaning of balancing? We try to attain different body postures. Like if we are standing, we need to maintain balance. We bend down, we need to maintain balance. We bend sideways, we sometimes lie down, we sometimes do our neck backside. In all these positions, we have to be into our consciousness, and the body has to maintain its own balance. That balancing is done with the help of cerebellum. Okay, and if I'll just explain you further, in case of when a person gets drunk, how he is unable to maintain the body postures. You have all seen a drunken person, he is not able to maintain posture. Why? Because this particular part of the brain gets affected, which is the cerebellum, which maintains the body. So that is how alcohol affects our body, and that is how a person is unable to maintain the balance. Alright, because this particular part gets affected. So this is just an overall chart which explain you the different parts of brain along with their different functions. Now I'll explain you with the help of diagram what are these different parts and where are they located. So let us look into that.
So student, this diagram that you are watching right now is the structure of a human brain. So we have already discussed the different parts with the help of that flowchart. So we all know that now there are three main parts of brain, which are forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. So the basic two parts which we discussed as per your syllabus in forebrain were the cranium and the cerebrum. So what are these two? Let us try to see that. Now we all know cranium is particularly or generally known as skull. So what is this skull? The bony socket which is present around the face. So the part which covers the brain, the backside, which covers all this part, the bony part, is known as the cranium. If you have ever seen a human skeleton, so the facial part which you see, and that facial part, particularly the part which covers the brain, the part inside which the brain resides, is known as the cranium. And what is this cerebrum? Now, if I'll ask you, like, if you have ever seen the structure of a brain in any of the Discovery Channel or in any of the laboratory, you might have seen pinkish coil, various coil kind of a structure which appears on the front part of the brain. And these irregular coils which you see are actually known as the cerebrum. So these two parts make up the frontal part of the brain. Now, what is this mid part of the brain? So the midbrain contains the basic part which is known as what? Hypothalamus. So this is the region of the hypothalamus. And the hindbrain, as we discussed, contains three main parts, which are pons, medulla oblongata and cerebellum. So what are pons? Just behind the hypothalamus is present this particular part which is pons, below which this part is known as the medulla oblongata part, and this particular part is known as the part which is known as cerebellum. So we have already discussed about the functions of each and every part, so I'm not going to discuss that again over here. In case if you have got doubt, you can ask to me, I'll be always responding for that. But you can watch the video ahead so that you can be clear about the different functions. And as I said you, that the hind brain or the lower brain is the part from where the spinal cord originates. So this is the place from where the spinal cord originates, from the hind brain. So this is the basic structure of human brain, and we have already discussed the different functions and parts of it. So I hope you are clear with the video. And as I say always, in case if you have got doubt, you can ask to me in the comment section box below. I'll be happy to help you out. And please do not forget to like my channel. Please do not forget to share the videos and subscribe to my channel. It always motivates me to work further for you.